I use natural consequences. I've always, I believe in a theory. I don't believe in physical abuse. I don't believe in embarrassment. I believe in consequences. If in fact you set the rules, you have rules in your family, and you sit down in a family meeting, which is part of what's important for families, to have family meetings, and you say what the rules are. And when you violate the rules, there's going to be a consequence. When a child's supposed to clean up their room. They do not clean up their room. You go into the room and everything that's out of place gets taken away and put in a box and maybe given away. If toys are not put away, you take a box one day and take some of those favorite toys. I would say initially, first you put them in a box and you put them away until a child learns to pick up their room, and then one by one they can take something back from the box. And if it continues, you take it and you give it away, because our kids have too much stuff anyway. Okay, and that's a very important lesson. If yelling and screaming goes on every morning before you're trying to get your child ready to go to school, all you have to do is say, you're going to get into the car at 8 o'clock in whatever state of dress or dress you are in, and you'll have to finish getting dressed in the car, and all you have to do is do that one time. And let me tell you something, they're going to get ready to go to school. Okay? Obviously, when they're teenagers, restricting their social activities. Now, taking away the phone would be the biggest consequence you could do. The inability to use the phone for even a day, or to take away social media, or to take away the things that are privileges. And in a more affluent family, children don't realize how many privileges they have. You know, as a parent, all you're required to do is feed, clothe, and house a child. In other words, their body has to be covered, they need some food, they need some shelter. Everything else is a privilege. A special shirt, tennis lessons, their room being decorated, going on vacation, those are all privileges. And they need to know that those are privileges. And so when we do not follow the rules, we lose privileges. The most effective way of discipline.